Today we will see about the continuation of the chapter 12 curses. Today we are going to see cursor for loops. Select for update cursor, where current of cursor, cursor with parameters and cursor variables. First, cursor for loops. How can we implement for loop and the cursor? So there is an option called cursor for loop, which is going to process the rows that is existing in the explicit cursor. So implicit open, fetch, exit and close operation that occurs in explicit cursor can be carried over with this cursor for loop. So the cursor is opened implicitly when the loop starts. A row is fetched once for each iteration in the loop. And the cursor is closed automatically when the loop ends. The loop ends when there are no more rows. So these are the implicit operations that can be carried over in an explicit cursor by using this cursor for loop. So the cursor for loop, if it is implemented, it can automate all the cursor action and it is a shortcut to process explicit cursor. These are two important points that can be seen in cursor for loop. So this is the syntax for the cursor for loop. For is a keyword, record name, in is a keyword, cursor name and loop is a keyword and end loop. These are the statements that occur in for loop. So what is the meaning by record name? It is the name of the record that is declared implicitly and destroyed when the loop ends. Cursor name is a declared explicit cursor name. So this is the record name and the cursor name. So this is an example for the cursor for loop. Here in the declaration section, the cursor is being declared at the name of employee cursor. And this is the cursor for loop. In the begin section, we are using this cursor for loop. But this employee cursor is an explicit cursor. But you are implicitly, you are going to execute the open and fetch operation by using this for loop. So when the loop starts, the cursor is open implicitly. Loop will execute. An implicit fetch retrieves the row into the record for processing for each loop iteration. And open, fetch and close statements are performed implicitly. Record columns are addressed with record name dot column name notation. Like this, record name dot column name notation. All the scope is being applied only within this loop body, only with this the scope exists. You can also implement this cursor for loops by using subqueries. So what is the difference between the cursor for loops using subqueries and the cursor for loop? By using this normal for loop is the difference lies in the cursor declaration. Cursor at end of the declare pannitingala adha poruthu for loop using subqueries and for loop abdingaratha differentiating a pannikalam. So if you are writing cursor for loops using subqueries, then you not declare the cursor in the declaration section. They just have to provide the select statement that determines the active set. And it cannot reference explicit cursor attributes if subquery is used. Explicit cursor attributes as per the path only four types that cannot be used in the subquery. So this is an example for an explicit cursor that can be used with implicit action. So what I'm going to do is this is the same example for end loop. So these are the operations that has been declared in the explicit cursor, but implicit open, implicit fetch, implicit close executes here. This program is used to retrieve the first name, last name, salary and commission of the particular employee record where your department ID is 10. So this is a general example how that cursor appears. This is the declare cursor part. Here you're declaring and exit means you're going to stop and there are no more records found. So before this exit, you can see that your cursor has been opened and looping and going to place output the value into this variable. So after this end, the value that has been retrieved is given here. Likewise, you can retrieve all the values into the records. The next topic is select for update cursor. Select for update cursor, what is the main purpose of using this is, whenever you use a select statement that has been linked with a cursor, there you are not implementing any lock facility. That is, you are not applying the lock to the particular record which what you have to return. For that purpose, the select for update statement can be used to log the records in the cursor results. That you can able to log the particular records in the cursor. The forward update class is used with select query for row locking. Row locking purpose kaha for update abingra in the clause use pandra cursor la. So row lock panitinga abina you have to release that. So for that you have to use the commit or rollback statement. Commit statement, rollback statement issue pandrappo record or lock will be released. So in general, the number of records logged at any given time is to absolutely minimum. Only those records which have been changed but not yet committed or locked. So select for update statement. ODB automatically obtains an exclusive role level locks on all the rows identified by the select statement. No one will be able to change these records until a rollback or commit statement is issued. So select for update statement use panitingana automatically role level lock vandha the select statement la potruvanga potrapadum. And release pandrakaga you have to issue a rollback or a commit statement. So this is the syntax for using that select for update. So cursor name is and select column name from table name where condition for update. This is the clause. So here it enables to specify the column names that is to be updated. Another user has already locked the table, so because it does not wait for the resource. If you are using that particular record, you can give this a message to the another user. So that they will not wait for this particular record set. They will move on to the other resource. Next clause is where current of clause. It is used to update or delete the record that was last fetched by the cursor. Last either fetch panicho and update pantrako or delete pantrako use panda the where current of clause. Record lock pantrako use panda the select for update. Ade mari record update panano delete panuna where current of clause use panu. But in the updating or deleting records from this, they must have been referenced by a select for update statement. Both delete and update statement inside a cursor range to make changes to the last fetched rows from the cursor with an easily manner. Syntax looks like update, table name, set clause, where current of cursor name. In the update name, we will set updating the cursor range to where current of updating the use control. They may delete from table name. Where current of cursor name. So where current of use panningana update panala delete panala record. Next comes of cursor with parameters. A parameter is a variable whose name is used in the cursor declaration. So when the cursor is open, the parameter value is passed to the Oracle server, which uses it to decide which rows to retrieve into the actual set of the cursor. So on the parameter value of purthu in the particular rows records வந்து active set க்கு அனுப்பணும்ங்கறதை டிசைட் பண்ணு. This means the user can open and close an explicit cursor several times in a block or in different execution of the same block returning a different active set on each occasion. So in the particular block வேணும்ங்கறத user வந்து டிசைட் பண்ணிக்கலாம். So different situation different occasion க்கு தகுந்த மாதிரி ஒரே particular block-அ different active set-ல they can able to open. So anga da ungalku inda parameter use aagudhu. So each parameter name in the cursor declaration must have a corresponding value in the open statement. Parameter that is a formal parameter passed to cursor. Data type may be a scalar data type. Only assigned data types can be used. You can only assign the data types to that parameter. You cannot able to assign the size. The parameter names can be used in the where clause of the cursor select statement. So the syntax panga cursor is appdin paathirukkom. So cursor name ku appuram parameter name data type nu solliralam. So when the cursor is open, values are passed to the cursor. Cursor open aanone values undu pass pannum and the values vandu positional order of the parameters ah irukum. That is respective ah neenga vandu the parameters values place pannirukanum. At the same time you can also able to pass the values through literals, pl bar sql variables or binary variables. Appadi kuda nama values pass panna mudiyum. The parameters in the cursor are passed into the cursor but cannot pass any value out of the cursor to the parameter. Parameter value in the cursor is very new values pass panna mudiyadhu. You can pass inside the cursor block. So this is an example of using the cursor with parameter. Declaration section, ingala variable, the cursor employee, ingada parameter varu. So department number, employee department ID, percentage type, abdi neenga mention pannirukonga. This is called as a parameter. So open panro employee cursor ID and the particular employees and department fresh panita and the particular ID order first name, last name, retrieve panirko in that with the help of the parameters. So you know the data type in a percentage type. Percentage type it returns to the column in the table. Abding a last plus button and the mother in a parameter value. So all of the explicit cursor are examples of the static cursor. Cursor is associated with one SQL statement and the statement is determined when the compilation of PL by SQL takes place. So a cursor variable can be associated with different statements at runtime. This is somewhat similar to the PL by SQL variables, which can hold different values at runtime. And the static cursors are similar to PL by SQL constants, which can only associated with runtime query. So these are the two difference between the cursor variable. That is, cursor variable, as the name says, it may have take different statements and runtime. So two types, cursor variables and static cursors. So what is meant by a cursor variable now? It can change its value. A cursor variable means it can change its value. That is, it can refer to different SQL statements at different times and can be opened with different queries within a program. Action statement like open, fetch, and close, and the cursor attribute is open, found, or not found, row found can be used with a cursor variable. Explicit cursor can enna pannanumo adellame vandu the cursor variable kum you can able to use. At the same time, it can also be assigned to another cursor variable. So what is meant by cursor variable? A variable that can change the value within the cursor. So in order to use the cursor variable, it must first be declared. So storage for it must be allocated at runtime, since a cursor variable is a reference type. That is, it is a reference type to a cursor. Two steps are involved in creating a cursor variable. First step is you have to create a reference cursor type. Second step is you have to declare an actual cursor variable with a reference cursor type. First of all, a reference cursor type create pannanum. Other reference pannanum an actual cursor variable declare pannanum. So this is a type of options that has been available in the syntax. Cursor type name. That is the name of the type of cursor. Return clause may be optional. And return type may be return data type and can be any valid data structure. Weak type, the cursor type declared without the return clause, you can call as a weak type. And the cursor type that has been declared with the return clause is called as a strong type. Without the return, weak type. With the return, you can call it as a strong type. So how you have to open the cursor variables is the syntax. Open cursor name, cursor variable name for select query. So cursor variable name, employee cursor variable, so the cursor type is declared with the return class. The structure from the select query must match the structure specified in the reference cursor declaration. The structure that has been returned by the select query matches the return type employee percentage row type. It is one match type. And how to fetch the data from the cursor variable is the compiler checks the data structure type after the into class to find if it matches the query linked to the cursor. This is the syntax, fetch cursor variable name into record name variable list. So this is what the cursor variable functions takes place. Cursor variables means reference cursor type, how to open and how to switch. So these are the topics that have been discussed in today's class. Cursor for loops, select for update, record lock pandrakaga, where current of class on the record update and delete pandrakaga, cursor with parameters and values pass panikalam. Cursor variable na variable change aayirukkudiya value cursor la irukku anga nama cursor variables nu solli adha reference cursor type declare panni nam open and fetch normally enna pandromo adha pannalam. So these are the topics that is available in cursors part in your chapter 12.